portion or phase.
Scenes from Meade High, Anne Arundel County government and school district leadership taking a tour and getting a progress report on the school's massive renovation project. More on that story in just a moment. Hello and welcome to Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. Also this week, a new Fort Meade shuttle is now in service, and a look at this year's Holocaust Remembrance Ceremony. These stories and more, but first, there are more than 7,800 registered volunteers in the Fort Meade community. In the past year, they gave up nearly 15,000 hours of their time. Army Community Services recognized some outstanding performers at this year's Volunteer of the Year Awards ceremony. We start with the Active Duty Volunteer of the Year, Sergeant John Beasley from the 21st Signal Brigade. He was nominated by the Fort Meade Spouses Club and helped the organization with their biggest events. The Youth Volunteer of the Year is Kaylee Hickson, nominated by the Thrift Shop. She volunteered 116 hours between the Spouses Club and the Thrift Shop and contributed another 75 to the Boy Scouts, all as a full-time high school student. The Volunteer Family of the Year are the Hicksons. Mom, Dad, and four children combined volunteered more than 2,000 hours serving the Fort Meade community. The Civilian Volunteer of the Year is Charles Stone, a volunteer at the USO. In 2023, he volunteered 732 hours, and as of February of this year, another 241. Child and Youth Services took a moment to recognize their volunteer youth sports coaches of the year for the winter, spring, and fall seasons. Frederick Wallace is the winter coach, Jared Amon Stewart the spring coach, and Philip Trost the fall volunteer coach. The Volunteer Coach of the Year award went to Terry Sargent. The last award went to the Volunteer Organization of the Year, the USO. USO volunteers contributed more than 9,200 hours, a 31% increase over the previous year.
Our volunteers have served over 14,850 hours. And we calculate this rate that's published by the Department of Labor at $31.80 an hour. So with that, I'd like to present you with this check for $472,277.70.
In other news, Anne Arundel County Transportation started a new shuttle bus service this week that runs between Fort Meade and the Odenton Marc station. There are six stops on the route: the Marc station, Dissa, Candlewood Suites, the Post Theater, Kimbrough Ambulatory Care Center, and the Office of Personnel Adjudications. The shuttle runs roughly every 30 to 40 minutes. The first shuttle leaves the Marc station at 6:16 in the morning, and the last one leaves at 5:35. Elsewhere, in 2020, Fort Meade and Anne Arundel County Public Schools announced plans for a massive renovation of Meade Senior High. Recently, Garrison Commander Colonel Michael Sapp, Anne Arundel County Executive Stuart Pittman, School Superintendent Dr. Mark Bedell, and other Anne Arundel County civic and business leaders took a brief tour to check out the progress.
Just wanted to emphasize the point, we're really excited for the opening of this building, and I do want to highlight the great work of our team and facilities, and Kyle Roof and Jeff Hagen, who like to stay behind the scenes. That's kind of the way they keep it, but I'd be remiss if I didn't thank them and the work and the entire construction crew and Eric and the work that's happening.
The ongoing renovations are adding 28,000 square feet of space and increasing student capacity to more than 2,500. The DOD kicked in close to $115 million of the more than $150 million cost of the project, and Arundel County provided close to $30 million. The renovations are projected to be completed by late December. We'll have more as the project nears completion. Meanwhile, the Fort Meade Equal Opportunity Office and Club Meade hosted this year's Holocaust Remembrance on May 9th. This year's guest speaker was Yvette Smith, a member of 3GDC, an organization of grandchildren of Holocaust survivors. During the observance, Smith related the story of her grandfather, Abe Rosenblum.
And the Hungarian government collapsed. The Germans came in and occupied Hungary, and then they didn't know what to do with us. They put us into a ghetto in a town called Košice.
He taught me about my Judaism, my morals, my values, my everything. He taught me what it means to advocate for others. He taught me about the importance of education. He taught me why we fight for justice, how to create a more equitable world, and how to show love and compassion to every single human.
And finally this week, the Association of the United States Army is hosting an Army birthday celebration on Saturday, June 15th from 10 to 4 at Burba Park. Everyone's welcome. The celebration includes food, games, and the cutting of the traditional birthday cake and more. Tickets are available online. Go to army-bbq.cheddarup.com. And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.